In the last class, we discussed the parallelism. So, for example, for the parallelism, so mobile, just you can take it down. The website must be based on the multi-tenant user, means the multiple computers we are using. For example, just you can take the VTU results. The VTU results, suppose the US, the fifth semester results will be out at a time. The n number of the users will be used at a time. This one is nothing but the one of the example for the parallelism for the single machine computation. And next one is the mobile app. For example, the Google Play Store. So this is one of the another example for the parallelism. Means the all the applications should be stored in your cloud. Means just you can directly, for example, Google Drive. Suppose if you want any voice recorder or any screen recorder, so in that case just you can use go Google Play Store. So just you can type the whatever if you want applications, for example, agent scanner or recorder or anything. Just you can type, then automatically it will be installed in your the mobile that you can use. Okay, this is one of the example for using the mobile applications. So these all comes under the parallelism. And next one is so these all things already covered: implicit threading, explicit threading. So what is thread? What is the relationship between threads as well as a process? And next, so one relationship between how exactly the process and threads will be works. How exactly the threads enter into the main thread and how exactly the main thread will be works after the completion of the sending the threads from the shared memory to the main thread. How exactly the instructions will be executed with help of the process. So already this one is also explained in the last class. And next one is the POSIX thread. So the here the POSIX we are using the two APIs. The first one is the POSIX threads as well as the threading supports Java and .NET. The first one is the POSIX thread. The POSIX thread is nothing but the portable operating. This one is one of the portable operating system we are using in Unix. So almost you are using the POSIX threads in Unix. So in the Unix, we are having the different types of the commands will be there. Just you can use the different, for example, the pipe like that. The pipe, one more. There are some n number of the commands will be there. Just you can use that commands, and then you can use run the applications with help of programming interface applications with help of the Unix operating systems. For example, just you can run these all with help of the POSIX, Linux as well as the Ubuntu. So you can use the any operating systems. So not specified. Yes, you can use only the XP or any Windows 7 in Windows 8 like that. He has not specified any operating system. Unix operating system. So operating system here you can use only Ubuntu as well as the Unix, Linux or Unix or open source. So then only the POSIX threads will be works. And here we are having some important programming points. First one is the thread can be identified the sequence of the instruction. The sequence of the instruction means nothing but here we are using the n number of the processors as well as the shared memory. The first thread enters into the main thread. So in that main thread, after entering to the main thread, so it is the execution process will be starts. After starting the execution process, so it will be having the each thread having some lifetime. After the completion of the lifetime of that thread span, so automatically the thread enters into the main thread, nothing but the thread local storage. So once again we are using the simple storage system. You can store the n of the instructions of that program, all the threads. Means suppose if you're entering the 1 2 3, just you can take the three threads. Okay, so after entering the third thread, automatically your thread will be sent to the main, means acknowledgement sent to the main thread. After the thread will be stored to the main thread local storage with help of the H3. So all the instructions will be stored into the processors. Means they have some extension of that thread after the completion of the threads entry. So automatically the your system will be like completed, means the main processor will be showing the how many threads will be entered, means like the later it will be shows the acknowledgement, means like that the sequence of the instruction will be executed. The first thread will be enters into the main thread after entering the main thread. So once again it will be checks the execution of that all the programs after checking the total lifetime of that thread, means the how many space are required for storing that thread after the process will be completely executing or not. So like that there are some several steps will be there, nothing but the that's after executing that several steps, then all the instructions will be stored in the processor. Otherwise the process the instructions will be not stored in that the processes. So this is nothing but the one of them, the main important part, logical sequence instructions. And actually the threads are mapped the functions. It will contain the sequence of the instructions to be executed. First it should be a sequence of the instruction. The sequence of the instruction is nothing but the main, if you are sending the passing the n number of the threads from the shared memory to processors, okay, the first thread will be enters to the main memory or main thread. So it will be checks the all the conditions, then the next threads will be entered, like that it will be enters to the next again, means n number of the threads will be enters, means suppose the main thread will be enters, okay, it will be satisfy the all the conditions. There are some conditions will be there, so all the condition means the storage space and some instruction it will be satisfying. After the satisfying that instructions, then only the threads will be stored in the main thread, otherwise the thread will be not executed. Like that after satisfying the threads only, then the next thread will be enters, means first thread should be execute successfully, then the second threads will be enters, otherwise the next thread will be not entered. Like that the thread first you can map the all the functions, after the mapping the function then the sequence of the instructions will be executed, otherwise the sequence of the instruction will be not executed. And next the thread can be created, terminated or the join. The created, terminated and join means suppose after the completion of the one thread, if you want one more thread just you can create the thread, and suppose if you want to stop the thread means just you can terminate the all the process, means after the completion of the entering the two or three threads, if you want to stop the thread just you can use the stop. In the last class just I discussed the life cycle of that thread, and resuming and stopping will be there. Just you can use that resume and stopping, automatically you can terminate all the threads, as well as the sequence of the sequence of the states that will be undergoes the some partly having some different types of the operating systems. So this operating system having some schedulers as well as the partly they are application developers, nothing but operating system scheduler means here the each thread having the schedules, means suppose the means the, if you are sending the n number of the threads, okay, the first thread complete means the each thread having the certain time, okay, first I am sending the shared memory to the first thread to processors. So just for I'm sending the three threads, okay, each thread having the 3 minutes, or if you just you can give the two minutes for the each thread. After the completion of the 2 minutes, then only the next thread will be enters to the main thread, otherwise the main next thread will be not enters. This one is nothing but the scheduler. And one more thing, the partly you can use the scheduler as well as the you can use partly the application developer, means if you want to develop the applications, the first you can use the thread local storage as well as the instruction. If you are not followed any instructions as a local storage of that thread, you cannot develop the application for that the main threads. And next one is the thread shared memory having the processes. The process is nothing but suppose if you send the threads from the shared memory to the main processors, means the each thread having the certain instructions. After entering the one thread to another thread, so they're having the the time restrictions will be there. After the completion of after entering the for example, suppose if you're sending the first thread, okay, here the instructions are satisfying, So after nothing but the program counter. So after satisfying the all instruction, then it will be enters to the thread local storage. Then the local storage to it will be entered to the main thread. The main thread to enter once again it will be sent to the processors. Like that, it should be satisfying the all the processes. Then only all the threads will be sent to the main thread to processors. Otherwise, it will be not sent to the main thread to the processors. This one is one of the important. Then you can synchronize the all the different problems with help of the different synchronized with help of the these threads, with help of the shared memory as well as the processes. Here we are using some extensions of the threads. And next one is the threading supports Java as well as the .NET. So this one is a familiar for you. The Java and .NET, the same languages we are using here. With help of the common operations of the threads, same once again here we are using start, stop, suspend, resume, abort, sleep, join and interpret, the same operations we are using here, as well as the suppose if you want to start as well as stop, just you can use the control lifetime of the thread instances. Okay, here if you are passing the n number of the threads, okay, in shared memory to the processors. So the each thread having the stop, start and stop. Suppose if you want to start as well as stop, so each thread having the certain scheduling, means certain time. After the completion of the certain time, automatically that thread will be switch off, means automatically it will be off. Then it will be sent to the thread local storage to the main thread. Like that, in middle, if you want to stop, so once you can stop the that thread, once if you are not satisfying that instructions, that will be not enters to the processes or the extensions of that thread. Otherwise that once again that it will be sent to the shared memory. And next, I suppose if it is the suspended as well as a resume, so here nothing but the if you want to pause or continue, just you can use the extension of the thread. Here we are having the the common operation for thread, the stop, start, suspend, resume, abort, sleep and join as well as the interrupt. So if you want the pause, just you can use a pause option, also nothing but the suspended. As well as if you want to continue this, you can use the resume operation. And the same operations once again you are using the sleep operations. This is used for execution of your the thread some predefined period of time. And this next operation is a join operation. This is used for the thread wait until the thread will be completed. So nothing but this is used for the waiting state. Suppose if there's an interpreted by using any interpret operation, just you can use the help of the that join by using the threading support the Java and .NET. So normally the POSIX threads, just you can use the same instruction, the same operation in that POSIX threads. We are using the created, terminated as well as a join. The only the three options will be there, but with help of the Java as well as .NET, we are using this start, stop, suspended, abort, sleep as well as join and interrupt will be there. The five operations you can execute. And next one is the parallel computation with thread. We are having the different techniques here. The first is the domain decomposition, functional decomposition as well as the computation versus communication. First one is the domain decomposition. Domain decomposition is nothing but here we are having the n number of processes. You can identify the patterns with respect to functionality. Nothing but it is a dependent or not. Okay, if it is dependent, just you can use the it is depend. Suppose if it is dependent, just you can take if it is computation data or not. Means here we are using the common type of the decomposition, common driver decompose is nothing but with respect to just you can identify the system is divided into the two major code segments, nothing but here in that decompositions we are using the master as well as slave model. This is a quite common organization in this decomposition. The first one is the master as well as same as is the map reducer. So here we are using the mapper as well as the reducer. So just you can send the mapper means the master as well as the slave. So you can send the n number of the data. So n number of the data means you can give the any data sets. So in the, after giving the data sets once again, so it will combine the all the data whatever if you are sending the data from the master to slave. Okay, after combining the data, one more option will be the shuffler. So it will shuffle the all the data. Suppose if you are sending the for example, if you are studying ML subject, in that one data set he has given sunny, rainy, like that. So overcast. Okay, so how many sunnies will be there, rainies will be there, overcast will be there. So automatically it will be calculated. So after combining the all the data, after combining the data, once it will be shuffle the all the data means the how many sunnies will be there, how many rainies will be there. So automatically it will be recalculated, then it will be sent to the master. Okay, after means after sending the master is nothing but here, sorry, the master to slave, the reducer. Okay, the combiner to it will be sent to the output is nothing but a reducer, is nothing but a slave. So in that slave you will get the so how many the sunny will be there and how many rainy will be there, like that. So here in the normal data set if I give the n number of the data. Okay, so automatically the combiner will combine the all the data. After combining the data, it will be sent to the shuffler. It will be shuffles once again. After shuffling, then it will be sent to the slave. And slave whatever data if you are sending from master to slave. So in middle the combiner slave will be there. Automatically the all the data will be combined. After combining, suppose if you are sending like VSMIT, so VSMIT, then the Nippani, like that. If you're sending the number of the data, if sending from the master, so in the shuffler it will shuffles the all the data, the Nippani, VSMIT, like that. Then the combiner it will combine. So the VSMIT, the two, suppose if you're sending the two data, it will be represented as a two, and then Nippani, two, like that. So it will be displaying the all the data with help. It will be combines the all the data. After combining the data, whatever combine will be done. No, so it's the same data, it will be represented in the slave side. This is nothing but a reducer. So like that, in the domain decomposition, the same the master slave model will be works. And next the system will be divided into the main two code segment. Okay, the first you can decompose the all data as well as you can coordinate the logics, and the second just you can use the with respect of the performance means how exactly the master is sending the data. After sending the data, how exactly the the shuffler as well as combining will be works. After working of shuffler as well as the combiner, then how exactly the combiner will be sends the data to the reducer. So these all comes under the performance of the data. Here next, the first the master thread execute the first code segment, nothing but whatever if you are sending the data. So it will be start for the execution, and the result of the master thread execution and the slave thread will be needs to create execution of the respect to the computation means whatever if you send the data, the in middle the process is nothing but the combiner as well as shuffler will shuffle all the data, and it will be produces some output, nothing but the VSMIT2 and the Nippani2, like that, Sunny, Rainy, as well as like that, whatever if you are sending the data sets. So it will be represented the means there are n number of the data will be there. It will be combines the all the data. After combining the data, so one more result will be represented in combiners. So directly it will be sent to the the slave is nothing but your the reducer. So this is nothing but the domain decomposition. After using the domain decomposition, so one more method will be there, the functional decomposition, as well as the computation, as well as the communication. This one I will continue in next class. Here the functional decomposition, having the some mathematical functions, so with help of the sine, cos, as well as the tan, how to use sine function, cos function, as well as the tan function. And in the decomposition, once again we are in domain decomposition technique, one more method we are using, the embarrassingly parallel. So embarrassing parallel is nothing but here it will be decomposing all the data, and then after decomposing the data, how exactly the sequentially it will be transporting the data from the one process to the another process. Means in middle we are having the unit of the works, that means the n number of the unit work will be there. So how exactly the each unit of the works will be works. So he has done some calculations, embarrassing parallelly means here using the two conditions with the performance of that matrix product. The first, he has taken the input matrix, nothing but it containing the how that values will be comparable with the nature of that result. Means nothing but he is using the unit of the works. So nothing but he are using some scalar product. And next, the number of the columns with help of the first matrices, as well as the how exactly it matches to the number of the rows of the second matrices. He has given he has provided the overview of the matrix product performance. Means he is using the A into B1 matrices, A and B, how exactly he has taken 4 into 5 and 6 into 3, how exactly this matrix will be works. So next class I will explain this one. So if you have any doubt up to the domain decomposition, please you can ask.